بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Learn Arabic grammar the easy way. In this lesson, we will learn the nouns like Muslim, Mu'min, Mushrik, Kafir, Salih, and how to make the plurals. We learn grammar using TPI, which is total physical interaction, using total physical parts like ears, eyes, brain, voice, hands, heart, and so on, to make it easy, interesting, and interactive. So what is TPI? Can you do TPI with TPI? Hear it, see
hear
it,
think
it,
think it,
say it, show it,
love it,
do it,
do
together.
It together.
Okay, doing it. You know, 3-3-1. Again, hear it, see
hear
it,
it,
think it.
Think it.
Say it,
say
show
it,
it,
love
it.
Love
do
it,
it together.
Do it together.
MashaAllah. In the last lesson, we have learned huwa, hum, anta, ana, antum, nahnu. Can you translate with TPI? Huwa,
he,
hum,
they,
anta,
you,
ana.
I,
Antum,
you are,
Nahnu, we are.
We.
Okay, can you repeat after me in Arabic? Huwa, hum.
Huwa, hum.
Anta, ana.
Anta, ana.
Antum, Nahnu.
Antum, Nahnu.
Nahnu. Once more. Huwa, hum.
Huwa, hum.
Anta, ana.
Anta, ana.
Antum, Nahnu.
Antum, Nahnu.
MashaAllah. And we also did questions and answers. So, can you answer? Man huwa?
Huwa Muslim.
Muslim. Man hum?
Hum
Muslimun. And this was anta ana, antum nahnu. Here the switch is there. Anta will become I. Who are you? I am a Muslim. Who are you all? Nahnu Muslimun. So can you answer me? Man anta?
Ana Muslim.
Man antum?
Nahnu Muslimun.
MashaAllah. Now let us take new lesson. We have broken the lesson into parts of 1 minute or 2 minutes, 3 minutes, like that. After every part, you can pause and practice with your friend. That's the best way. This way you can learn the whole lesson very easily. And all of these activities will take around 30 minutes or even less. So let's take the first part. Arabic words are of three types: ism, fi'l, harf. Ism means noun, like names like kitab, makkah, or attributes like Muslim, mu'min. Fi'l is verb which shows an action or tells us about an action. Fataha, he opened, ya'malun, they are doing, and so on. And harf means particle, which joins the nouns or joins the verbs, or simply any word which is not ism and not a fi'l is harf. Simple. So what are the three types? Ism means noun, fi'l means verb, and harf means particle. Or just say it in Arabic. Repeat after me. Ism, fi'l, harf.
Ism, fi'l, harf.
Once again. Ism, fi'l, harf.
Ism, fi'l, harf.
Lastly, ism. Oh, we learned that Bismillah, ism is name or noun. So, ism, fi'l, harf.
Ism, fi'l, harf.
Allim, teach. Okay, that was like 1 minute. So, let us take the second part. There are common nouns in Arabic like kitabun, a book. You know the ending sound. The ending double fatha or double dhamma, dopesh, will make it a book. Kitabun, a book. And Arabic is interesting, amazing Arabic. That's the logo there. Means if it is a book, any book, you don't have to add special word to it. Like in English, you have a book. In Arabic, you just say kitabun. Even if you don't say kitabun, just say kitab, it's okay. But when you want to say specific book, you have to add l, the, just l, it means the. But because in Arabic you don't start with silent letters, you put Hamza before that al. Okay, you know, in English we have problem. For example, for our people, like school, in English you start with kind of silent letters school, and because we are not used to it, some people say school and some people say sakul or street. So some people say street and some people say satreet. Both are wrong. But anyway, in Arabic, because you don't start with silent letters, so you have to add hamza there, al. So al means the. Actually it is l means the lam. So if you want to say the book, it will be al kitabu. You don't say al kitabun, just like in English you don't say the a book, because kitabun means a book. So when you have al, un will go. Very simple. So kitabun means a book. Al kitabu, the book. Kitabun, a book. Al kitabu, the book. You add al there, then you have to cancel un. Just put one. Al kitabu. Kitabun, al kitabu. Teach your friend. Allim. Okay, let's take third point now. Just the practice of that. I will say Muslimun. We are taking five nouns. Ism, plural is asma. Okay, we took that. So we are taking here five asma. What are they? Muslim. Muslim, you know, Muslim is a Muslim. Mu'min, believer. Salih, good man, pious person. Salih, and it's the name of Prophet also. But Salih means good person, pious person, pious. Kafir, disbeliever. Mushrik, polytheist, one who associates people with Allah. So Muslim means the one who submits. Mu'min, believer. Salih, pious man. Kafir, disbeliever. And Mushrik, polytheist. Can you translate? Muslim, the one who submits. Mu'min, believer. Salih, pious man. Kafir, disbeliever. Mushrik, polytheist. Allim, teach your friend. Okay, now I am taking Muslimun and you will add al to it. Al Muslimu. Un will go. So if I say Muslimun, you will say Al Muslimu. Mu'minun, Al Mu'minu. Salihun, As Salihu. Kafirun, Al Kafiru. Mushrikun, Al Mushriku. Once again, Muslimun, المسلم مؤمن المؤمن صالح الصالح كافر الكافر مشرك المشرك ما شاء الله علم. Okay, let's take fourth point here. So I'm sure now you're getting these points very easy, and by practicing and writing, preferably you can write these also when you take a break, then you will learn them very easily and strongly, effectively. So let's take the fourth point. What we are saying is, to make it easy, we are not putting harakat at the end, like Muslimun. We are not saying, we just say Muslim, because Muslimun can be Musliman, it can be Muslimin, or it can be Muslima, Muslimi, Muslimu. Okay, so just say Muslim for now. We'll learn that later on when it is un and in and so on. So Muslim, Mu'min, Salih, Kafir, Mushrik. Now we will learn how to make plurals. Okay, like, and you have learnt it in the and practiced it in the first lesson also. Plural of Muslim is Muslimun, or it can be Muslimin. When it is Muslimun, the plural is Muslimun. It is Musliman or Muslimin, the plural is Muslimin. But as of now, to make learning easy, just say plural of Muslim is Muslimun or Muslimin. Simple. So just add un or in to make the plural. This is one way. There are other ways, but this is one very common way, simple way. And it has been used a lot. So can you give me the plurals? That's the practice. Muslim,
Muslimun,
Muslimin. Mu'min,
Mu'minun,
Mu'minin. صالح
صالحون
صالحين. كافر
كافرون
كافرين مشرك
مشركون
مشركين ما شاء الله once again مسلم
مسلمون
مسلمين
مؤمن
مؤمنون مؤمنين
صالح
صالحون صالحين كافر
كافرون
كافرين مشرك
مشركون
مشركين علم teach علم means teach your friend okay let's take fifth point the whole lesson as I said is broken into small units so you can take one at a time otherwise in the book it's just one page so what are the signs of nouns that we have learned sign of an ism or noun is it starts with al it has al in the beginning or un an in un in or at at the end what is at that is muslimat we will learn later on but remember al in the beginning un an in un in at the end one of them again last time what is in the beginning al it can have al in the beginning or un an in un in at the end it can be u e a also but let's take this simple definition can you teach your friend alim so here is a logo al in the beginning or un in un an in or un in at the end can you teach your friend alim okay let us take sixth point which is nothing but practice and you already did it as an answer which is man huwa muslim so you know that so can you translate with actions please huwa muslim
he is a muslim
hum muslimun
they are muslims
anta muslim
you are muslim
a muslim ana muslim
I am a muslim
antum muslimun
you are muslims
nahnu muslimun
we are muslims
you did that so can you repeat just once after me in arabic using actions huwa muslim
huwa muslim
hum muslimun
hum muslimun
انت مسلم
انت مسلم
انت مسلم
انا مسلم
انتم مسلمون
انتم مسلمون
نحن مسلمون
نحن مسلمون
ما شاء الله علم practice okay let's take the seventh and the last unit which is spoken arabic before we do that let's take a new word hal it's a question word it when it comes in the beginning It can mean is, am, are, do, you know, whatever, depending on the context or the question. Hal occurs in the Quran 93 times. So let's take an example. We learned huwa Muslim. So I am asking hal huwa Muslim and all of them answer it in yes. And na'am means yes. Na'am means yes. Okay. So hal huwa Muslim is he a Muslim? You'll say, Naam, yes, huwa Muslim. And I will add hal to all these questions. So if I say, hal, hum Muslimun, are they Muslims? Naam, hum Muslimun, yes, they are Muslims. So hal can mean, if it is singular, is hal, are. Don't worry, just say hal is a question word. Can you answer me in Arabic? Very simple. Hal, huwa Muslim?
Naam, huwa Muslim.
Naam. هو مسلم هل هم مسلمون
نعم
هم مسلمون once more هل هو مسلم
نعم هو مسلم
هل هم مسلمون
نعم
هم مسلمون علم practice okay let's talk about you and me and you all and we all أنت أنا أنتم نحن it's very interesting أنت أنا أنتم نحن so هل أنت مسلم؟
نعم.
نعم أنا مسلم هل أنتم مسلمون؟ نعم
نعم
نحن مسلمون Once again answer me in Arabic with actions هل أنت مسلم؟
نعم
So you will say نعم أنا مسلم with this action only هل أنتم مسلمون؟ نعم
نحن مسلمون
Now, علم, teach your friend. You will ask and he will answer with actions. Now, let's take the learning tip. use it or lose it. I mean the brain. Use your brain or lose your brain. We hardly use 5% to 25% of our brain, at least in terms of its capacity. It can do a lot. For senior citizens, only up to 3% of brain cells die when you reach 60 years of age. Because, you know, when people get old, they say, well, this is not the time to learn. I'm too old. Don't ever shaitan distract you from learning the Quran. Don't let him misguide you that you are too old and cannot learn. Remember, still you have 97% of your brain intact. And for brain and for muscles, exercise is must. And it's more important for aged people. Otherwise, cells will start dying. That means use them or lose them. Then why not learn the Quran, which has special blessings too? And I've seen people who are 75 years of age and still memorizing the Quran, mashallah, and have memorized the Quran, 70 years of age, memorized the Quran. Alhamdulillah, by the end of this lesson, second lesson, we have learned 27 words which occur in the Quran almost 8,600 times. Don't forget the 7 homework, 2 on tilawa, 5 minutes from the Mus'haf, 5 minutes while walking or doing ordinary things. 2 on study, at least 10 minutes of from the book, this course book, and keeping the vocabulary sheet and referring to it again and again, half a minute, 15 seconds, no problem. And listen to the 1 hour recording, talk about the course, and recite different surahs in salah. And 2 du'as, one for yourself, Rabbi Zidni Ilma, and for your friends, O Allah, help us to learn the Quran in Quran class. Why? Because it is, you know, it makes you regular. And be a teacher if you can. That's the best recipe to learn. The best way to learn is to teach. Download the PowerPoint files and start teaching. And you can even use the videos and pause every 5 minutes and let, you know, everyone practice and then continue. Or you can have teachers training at our website, understandquran.com. May Allah help us to recite, understand, ponder, implement, propagate, and memorize the Quran. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Quran, learn Tajweed, understand the Quran and memorize it using easy, scientific and interactive methods. Get ebooks, videos, audios, posters, PowerPoint files, app links for different courses. We have specialized Montessori materials and games for making the Quran easy for kids and a teacher's resource center too. Get personalized one-to-one online courses that suit your needs from expert teachers. For free trial, write to admin@understandquran.com or visit understandquran.com. Wassalam.